In this tutorial, we are going to create Magical Fantasy image number 5. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the images in the video description. Go to File and click on New. We will make a canvas with the default size of 9020 by 1080. Just click OK. Make sure that all the settings of GIMP are default. Go again to File and now to Open as Layers. Here we can search for our first image and open it. Zoom out a bit by pressing the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel towards you. Activate the Unify Transform tool. In the tool options, we make the image opacity about 50. Click in the image. Click and drag the handles and the corners to transform the image like so. When you grab the corners, we must grab the square but not the diamond in it. When we grab the diamond, we change the perspective, but for now we only want to scale and reposition the image. We can click Reset to start anew, but we can also click Ctrl Z to undo the last step. When we feel it's okay, we can click Transform. Zoom in a bit by pressing the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel away from you. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Layer Mask. Make it white, full opacity, and click Add. Activate the gradient tool in the toolbox. Make sure you have the custom gradient, which goes from black to white. With the reverse button, we can change this direction. Click and draw a line upwards. We can grab the begin and or the end point to make corrections. We can also hover with the mouse over the line, and there will appear a third point which we can also move. Hit Enter on your keyboard to apply. Back to File, click on Open as Layers, search for the second image and open it. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Alpha Channel. We are going to remove the sky. Activate the Fuzzy Select tool. Click on the second button of the mode, which is Add to Current Selection. Now we can click again and again in the sky until we have selected the whole sky. Click on Select in the menu bar and then on Feather. We feather the selection with 5 pixels. Click OK. Go to Edit and hit Clear to remove the sky. Now go to Select and hit None to remove the selection lines. Press Shift-T to activate the Transform tool again. Right away the framework pops up. Scale the image and move it to the bottom of the canvas like so. Press Enter to confirm. Now we go to Colors and hit Brightness and Contrast. Reduce the brightness to its maximum. This can be done with the slider, but you can also click and hold somewhere in the image and then move the mouse pointer. Up and down changes the brightness, and left and right changes the contrast. Then we click OK. Go to Filters, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the value for the X as well as the Y 1. And then click OK. Time now to open the image with the snow goose. Go to File, Open, search for the image and open it. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Alpha Channel. Press the U key to make the fuzzy select tool active again. Click several times in the image until the whole sky is selected. Then we go to Select and click on Grow. We grow the selection with 1 pixel and click OK. Back to Select and now to Feather. Here we can just click OK to feather the selection with 5 pixels. Click on Edit and hit Clear, so the sky is removed. Again to Select and now to None to deselect. Click and drag the thumbnail of the goose image via the thumbnail of the project into the project. Double-click on the name and rename it Snow Goose. Hit Enter to confirm. Now we press Shift-T to bring up the Transform framework again. Zoom out. The image opacity is still 50%. Notice that the layer itself is momentarily invisible. Press and hold the Shift key so the proportions stay intact. Then scale the image down by grabbing the square. This lights up yellow. Let go of the Shift key and move the image. When you feel it's okay, you can hit Enter or click Transform. When the goose is in its place, we are going to open the image of the girl. Go to File, Open, and open the photo with the girl. Right-click on the layer and click on Add Alpha Channel. Here too, we are going to remove the background. Activate the selection tool of your choice. I've chosen for the Paths tool. Zoom in and click the first note. Then we can place the second note. Hold the left mouse button down and drag it out a bit so we see the handle. Now we make a curve and then we let go of the mouse. Click and drag the handle back to its note. Click the next note, hold the mouse, drag out the handle, make a curve, release the mouse, and place the handle back to its node. And that's how the Paths tool works. With Ctrl Z, we can undo one or more steps. Press and hold the spacebar, we can, by moving the mouse without clicking, move the image. We will go fast forward now. When we are at the back of the dress, we skip the outer part because of the background that shines through. Close to the first note, we can hover over it, press and hold the Ctrl key, and when the little chain is visible, we can click to close the path. We can still make corrections like so. Press Ctrl Shift J to maximize the image in the window. Now we click on the button Selection from Path to make our selection. Go to Select and hit Feather. We feather the selection with 5 pixels again and click OK. Press Ctrl I to invert the selection so the background is selected. Now go to Edit and click Clear or hit the Delete key. This removes the background. Then we drag and drop the thumbnail of the girl image via the thumbnail of our project into our project. Double click on the name and fill in Girl. Hit Enter to confirm. Press Shift-T to activate the Unified Transform tool again. Press and hold the Shift key to constrain the proportions when we scale. With Ctrl Z we can undo our last step. Click in one of the squares in the corner so the outline lights up yellow. Scale the image down, like so. Click and drag inside the image to move it. When we feel it's okay, we click on the Transform button. Activate the Eraser tool. Choose Brush Hardness 0.75 and make the size about 10. Erase parts of the dress like shown in the video. Thank you. right-click on the girl layer and hit Alpha to Selection. Then press Ctrl-Shift-D to make a duplicate of this layer. Double-click on the name and rename it Girl Shadow. Hit Enter. Make sure that black is your foreground color. Then we can drag and drop this black into the image. Make the opacity of this layer about 60. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. Then press Shift plus E to make the eraser tool active again. Make the opacity about 50. Choose brush hardness 25 and make the size about 50. We can carefully erase parts of the face, the dress, arms, the knee and the foot. Here too we can use Ctrl-Z to undo one or more previous steps. When you think it's enough, we right-click on the girl's shadow layer and hit Merge Down. Now choose brush Acrylic 3. Make the size about 10. We can erase a bit of the leg of the girl to make it look like it's in the fur of the goose. Press the P key to make the paintbrush active. Make the opacity about 20. Choose brush hardness 25. Make its size about 30. Activate the snow goose layer. Make just a little bit of shadow under the feet of the girl. Hit Ctrl-Shift-J again. Now we click on the girl layer. Go to File, Open as Layers, select both goose images using the Shift key and open them. Again, press Shift plus T for the Transform tool. Move the image with one goose like so. Press and hold the Shift key and scale it down a bit. Then click Transform. Make the layer with the three geese active. Click in the image to bring up the framework of the Transform tool. Make this image also a bit smaller and move it to its proper position. Hit Transform again. Right-click on the top layer and hit Merge Down. Go to Colors, Brightness and Contrast. Make the brightness about plus 60, so all the geese become a bit lighter. Click OK. Then, by click and drag, we move the geese layer below the snow goose layer. Make the snow goose layer active. Press Ctrl-Shift-N to bring up the new layer dialog box. Rename it blue. Make the fill type transparency. And click OK. Click on the foreground color of the foreground background colors to make the color palette visible. Fill in the HTML notation 2, 7, 5, 7, 8, 8. Hit Enter to see the blue color in the current old preview pane. Now drag and drop this blue color into the image. Then we can close the color palette. We make the mode of this layer color HSL. The opacity should be about 60 to make the image, except the girl, a bit bluish. Activate the girl layer. Click on Colors and then on Color Temperature. Make the original color temperature about 9500. Then click OK. To finish off, we're going to create some snow. Press Ctrl-Shift-N to open the new layer dialog box. Name it Snow. Leave it at Transparency. And click OK. Hit the P key again to make the paintbrush active. Hit the X key to swap the foreground background colors. We now have white as our foreground color. Make the opacity 100. choose Brush Splats 01. Make the size about 200. Increase the spacing to about 100 to get a bit more space between the brush strokes. Click on Dynamics, scroll down and click on Track Direction. This changes the direction of the brush while we use it. Now we make long strokes over the image like so. Take care that you do not cover the face of the girl. When this is done, we go to the menu bar and click Filters, Blur and Linear Motion Blur. We make the length about 40. Make the angle about minus 30 by turning the wheel or moving the slider. When we click on Split View, we can see before and after. Satisfied? Click OK. Reduce the opacity to about 70. And there it is, Magical Fantasy Image number 5. I hope you enjoyed this workshop by making it or just watching the video. If that's the case, please do not forget to like it. Maybe leave a nice comment and subscribe if you haven't done already. All this really helps. Thank you very much for watching.